15 Years is my 15th novel, and that is very ironic, actually, that the title and the time span matches like that. It was not something that was planned by myself, not even something that was planned by the publisher. As a matter of fact, when I wrote this manuscript, it was not titled 15 Years. And when I turned it in to the publisher, I received a call from them telling me how much they thoroughly enjoyed it, but they wanted to change the title. And that was the first time in my career that a publisher has wanted to change the title of any of the manuscripts that I've turned in. And she told me that she wanted to change the title to 15 Years. And when she told me that, it just resonated with me. I loved it. I thought it was a better fit than the one that I had for it originally. And then when I realized that when they put it on their production schedule and at the time it would be coming out, it would be my 15th novel to have been published, it just, you know, was even made it even better with that. And so it has been quite a journey, you know, going through the process of becoming an author, a published author, and seeing how God has elevated my career over the years and seeing how he has just shown me such favor over the years with my writing. Everything that I have accomplished, I give him all the glory for it. I know that it is nothing that I have done, but it's because of his goodness and his favor upon my life that I have been able to reach many of the goals that I wanted to reach in my career as a writer. And I have not been writing that terribly long. I'm a young writer when you really take it into perspective. It's, you know, my 15th novel, but I have not been a published writer for 15 years. I started my career in 2002 when I self-published my first novel. So between 2002 and now, God has blessed me to be able to put 15 projects out there, and I'm very grateful for that. Every day has not been Sunday. Every day has not been easy. There have definitely been some pitfalls and some struggles and some hurdles along the way, but I have learned how to overcome those things. I have learned how to jump over the hurdles, to step around the pitfalls, all of those things, because they will come in life. I think every career has its struggles, has its hard points. I don't believe any of them come without any adversity whatsoever. But it's just a blessing when you're able to walk in your purpose, when you know what you're doing is basically what you were put on earth to do. And I think that makes it easier to be able to even face all of those things that may come up during the course of your career that may make it hard on certain days, or, you know, some days are better than other days. But the one thing that has remained steady throughout for me is that I love what I do. There's not a day that goes by that I hate what I do. Never do I hate the fact that I write or that I have a deadline approaching, you know. So I count that a blessing to have a job where there is no day that I hate getting started on my job. You know, there are days when I feel overwhelmed. There are days when I feel like I'm not producing what I want to produce in that 24-hour period, but there's no day that I don't like what I do. And I think, you know, that alone is enough, you know, for me to embrace what I do and not stand around and complain about it, because I don't think there are a lot of jobs out there that people can say that about, even the best of jobs. I think for most people have days that they just hate to get up in the morning, hate to clock in, hate to look into the boss's face, you know, those type of things. And I don't have that to deal with what I do. And so I'm very grateful for my career. And because I write for three publishing houses, there is always something on the horizon for me, you know, and that's a blessing, because in this business, busy is a very good thing. And so currently now I have two other books that will be coming out before the end of 2010. I have a book in July that will come out titled Song of Solomon, and that should be releasing on July 1st. It's coming through Urban Books, Urban Christian Imprint. And then in October, my very first nonfiction ministerial book will be releasing, and it is entitled I Shall Not Die. And it is a book that really accompanies a ministry that I launched earlier this year. As a matter of fact, I really launched it in October of 2009, and it's called I Shall Not Die. And this book is a ministerial tool that partners with that ministry. And so I'm looking forward to that book releasing in October. So by the end of the year, I will actually have 17 books that will be on the market. So I really have a lot of reason to be thankful and very little reason to complain. So I'm very grateful for those, and more information will be coming available on my website and by other means through uh, WNB publications to let people know when these works will be coming out. But I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to this being a good year.